One sec. You're at 18012 Ash Avenue, East Point, Michigan. At the stop sign, turn.
That show was at the Curling Club in Butley.
Getting older.
But I also, you know, I don't know how you feel about seasonal depression, but, you know, I'm affected by it. A lot of people are. I think I'm too old, though, to be a cutter. I think I'm too old to start cutting myself. But just, you know, it takes so much longer to heal now. My daughter says I'm too old to use the phrase, "Oh my God, I'm done right now." Too old to say that. I was asking my dad recently about erectile dysfunction medication. But, oh man, that's a lot to try and spell into a Ouija board. So let me get this straight. Tainted meat comes from the part of the animal between the genitals and the butthole. Can you tell that I've been lip syncing this whole time? Getting pretty good.
Listen to my show, Comic Strip, Mondays at 8 p.m. right here on Just for Last Canada. I kind of sit down with the funniest people ever. That's 8 p.m. Mondays right here, Just for Last Canada, and always available on the app.
Russell Peters, Deborah DiGiovanni, H. Trevor Wilson, Cheech and Chong, Allison Dorr, Brent Butt, Sugar Sammy, Courtney Gilmore, Jerry D, Harlan Williams, DJ Demers, Norm MacDonald, Michelle, Bobby Mayer, Dave Mahesh. Waitlist them all, but who's got time for that? Just for Last Canada on Sirius XM.
Man, thanks for coming out, everybody. You guys are amazing. This has been a dream. I'm gonna leave you guys on this joke here. Tell me if you know what I'm talking about. You know when you're out in the world, living your life, doing your thing, right? You're not thinking about your butt at all. You're just out in the world, living your life, doing your thing. Maybe you're wearing suit pants on a bus. You're not thinking about whether or not your butt is clean or dirty. Why would you? You got a whole life of stuff to worry about. Now, if you're not thinking about it, hopefully, that's because your butt is clean. Because hopefully, clean is the default setting for your butt. In fact, I cannot imagine a scenario in which your butt would normally be dirty, but then you would be surprised to find that it felt clean all of a sudden. But I'm telling you, man, it certainly goes the other way. You know, when you're out in the world, just living your life, doing your thing, right? You're like not thinking about your butt, not thinking about your butt, not thinking about your butt. And then, what's going on here, right? I'm not talking about shitting your pants, guys. I'm not even talking about like a shart or a farts plus or whatever you want to call it. Because that's a thing that happens and you can feel it happen. I'm saying you're out in the world, living your life, doing your thing. You're like not thinking about your butt, not thinking about your butt, not thinking about your butt. And then there's a moment. Just a moment where you're like, I should probably check this out. I think maybe I need to get to a bathroom and check this out. You check it out. It's not brown. No, it's not brown. A little wet, maybe. Maybe it's the shadow of brown. Like a sepia. Like an old-timey Western photo. You're looking at it like, whoa, why is my family in cowboy clothes? But I used to ask people when I did this bit if they knew what I was talking about, and I'll tell you, people don't love volunteering that information. I don't see a lot of hands shoot up. They're like, I got a dirty butt now! I've been dirty down here right now! I'll tell you what. Every time I do this, every time, someone comes up to me after the show, and they're like, that happens to me. That's really brave what you do up there. And I'm talking about business women. Like CEOs and shit coming up to me, being like, you'd never guess it, but underneath this pencil skirt, I got a real hot mess down here. So I just want to know why it happens, you know? But I believe in karma. And I believe that karma can pay itself off in tiny, disgusting ways. You cut someone off in traffic today, maybe tomorrow, just out in the world, living your life, doing your thing, right? Maybe you're wearing suit pants on a bus. And it's like a filth spider. Stay with me, like a spider made entirely of filth. Just sort of crawls out of the hole and goes right back to sleep right on that hole. Be good to people.
This is JFL Canada.
I don't love getting my hair cut, you know what I mean? It's not that exciting for me. I can't get a cool haircut. I'm too old. You know what I mean? Young guys can go and get a haircut and be like, give me a tight fade. And they get it, they're like, tighter. I can't do that, you know what I mean? The only thing I guess I could do, they do that thing where young guys do now where they cut all their hair around the sides, leaving only the top hair, which I imagine for balding men is infuriating. That must suck so bad if the only hair you can grow is deemed useless by our most attractive generation. Yeah, getting a haircut for me is a chore. I think for a lot of women, it's a very exciting slash nerve-wracking time. My girlfriend will go in excited with things to do with her hair. One time she went in and dyed her hair brown. Her current hair color was also brown. I think she was bored. I don't know what she was doing. I heard the word ombre thrown around. I don't know what that is. But she came home and she was like, notice anything different? I'd be like, you have less money. My girlfriend's very nice, we don't fight very much. I thought she was mad at me for a while. Last year, it turned out she just got her eyebrows done, so. That was a misunderstanding. I don't think athletes make enough money. I don't. They should make a ton of money. They can get traded. I don't know what you guys do for a living. But I bet when you go to work in the morning, there's no threat of you suddenly having to work for a different company in a different city in exchange for another human being. That must be so stressful. Imagine you're 19 years old, you work at Subway. You go in, your manager calls you into the office, he's like, Timmy, come in here, I got bad news. So about? No.
Biggest names in comedy.
Like a lot of Canadians, I follow politics very closely when it's American. And one thing will always happen during American elections that blows my mind. No matter what, always a lot of left-wing American actors will threaten to move to Canada if the Republicans win. What are you talking about? Do you not know how much of a demotion it is to go from being a Hollywood actor to a Canadian actor? You're going to take an 1,000,000% pay cut to be in a show that ends with Of Green Gables? The rapper Drake has a song where he says that he started from the bottom. And the bottom he's talking about is when he was an actor on Canadian TV. Do you understand? That's where our rappers come from. In the United States, it's because of systemic urban poverty. Here, it's because entertainers do not get paid well. And so they must rap. But I do think you should always vote in every election. I think it's very important to vote. Some people, they won't vote if no one inspires them. They're like, none of these candidates inspire me, therefore I shall not choose. And if you think that, you don't understand how our system works. Because democracy is not about electing the best person. It's about not electing the worst. Do you understand the difference there? You're always trying to pick the least worst option. You're supposed to vote the same way you pick an avocado. It's like, no, 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 maybe. Then you get home and you're like, oh no, it's been bad the whole time. But we have hope that the next avocado, that one's gonna change things. Just because you're faced with a bad and a worse choice doesn't mean that not choosing is a good idea. If you're walking down the street, someone jumps out of an alleyway, like, give me your money or I'll attack you. You don't want to be like, neither of those inspires me. Ask me again in 4 years. This is not a popular thing to say, but I'm going to say it anyway. I have a lot of sympathy for politicians. Because imagine if every 4 years your boss was like, let's see if you get to keep your job. We're going to ask everyone to weigh in on how you've been doing. That's right. You're like, have they been reading or keeping track of my progress? No, not at all. They're going to look at your face and make a snap judgment.